Good morning. I am Shanti. I'm working as an assistant professor in Sri Ishwar College of Engineering. Now we will discuss about the code optimization in the compiler design subject. You already know the phases of compiler. The fifth phase of your compiler is the optimizer. The input to the optimizer is intermediate three address statements. The output to the code optimizer is optimized three address statements. Why we need optimizer? The aim of the code optimizer is it should produce faster running code and occupy the less memory space. During the optimization, the number of statements in a three address intermediate output of the intermediate code generator is reduced. Four statements into three statements. So that is called optimization here. So when number of statements are reduced, by default that will produce the faster running code and also it takes less memory space. Criteria for code improving transformations. We have to, when we are doing the transformations, we have to preserve the meaning of the source program and also we have to speed up the program. And this transformation must be the worth places for improvement. In what are all the places we can apply the optimizations? We can apply the optimization in the source code level or intermediate code level or in the target code level. During source code level, user can profile the program or change the algorithms or transform the sum of the loops. During that, through this process, you can optimize the codes in the source code level. Next, intermediate code level optimization. Here, compiler can improve the loops, procedure calls, and address calculation. Here, optimization is done between the loops. Next, target code. In this level, compiler can use the registers. It selects the instructions, that is efficient instructions, and also it applies the peepfold transformations. So, optimization, we can improve the code at these three levels. Next, you are having the, some constraints during the optimization. Some languages may not permit certain code improvements. For example, you can take array in C language. Versus Fortran. You cannot perform the any optimization on the array. Similarly, compiler must use machine resources efficiently. For example, a compiler uses registers that should accommodate the heavily used variables. And also it should be use the variety of addressing modes. Addressing modes also, the selection of addressing mode is also optimize the code. Next, organization of the code optimizer. First, you have to perform the control flow analysis, then data flow analysis, then transformations. After doing these three processes, your code will be optimized. And also, your code should be in the machine independent one. Before performing the optimization, you have to draw the control flow graph. To draw the control flow graph, you have to know, you need some basic plots. We will see what is basic plot now. Sequence of consecutive statements in which flow of control enters at the beginning and leaves at the end without halt or possibility of branching. This is called basic plot. What is basic plot? It is a plot. It contains the set of consecutive statements in which flow of control is enters at the beginning of the block and similarly that leaves end of the block. This is called basic block. It's partitioning into basic blocks. You can have the set of three address statements that is given as input to your code optimization. So you have to build the control flow graph for the set of three address statements. First you have to build the control flow graph. For that you need to partition the basic plots. Then you have to apply the links to develop the graph. First, you have to identify the leaders. In your three address statement, always the first statement is a leader. Any statement that is the target of a conditional or unconditional go-to is a leader. Third rule, any statement immediately following the go-to or conditional go-to is a leader. Group all statements from one leader to next. See, that is leader to leader, we have the basic blocks. See here, this is the quick start example. Here you are having the variables I, j, v, x. If n value is less than or equal to m, you can return the value. Your partition is started from here, I equal to m minus 1. You can study the, you can make the self-learning about the quick start. Now we are going to perform the optimization on this algorithm. First, you have to convert these quick start example into three address statements. So here each and every statement will be converted into three address statements. You see here your first statement is I is equal to m minus 1. So you are having the first statement I equal to m minus 1. Second one is j equal to n. So j equal to n. Third one is v equal to a of n. It is an array. Here n is the integer variable. It always occupies 4 bytes. So you are writing 4 into n. That is, you are having the n. The memory location is 4 into n. That because each location occupies 4 bytes. So n number of elements are there. So that will occupy n into 4 bytes. So you can store that into temporary variable t1 equal to 4 into n. Next, that will be assigned to the variable v. So v equal to a of t1. Then you are having the I is equal to I plus 1 statement. So I is equal to I plus 1. Then you are having a of I less than v. Then you have to convert a of I. So I is equal to I plus 1, t2 equal to, sorry, you already added I equal to I plus 1 from here. Next, you are having the A of I. That is, I occupies 4 bytes. So you can have the new temporary variable t2. That is equal to 4 into I. Next, that is assigned to the another variable t3. That is, A equal to A of t2. Next, you are setting if A of I less than V. So A of I is in temporary variable T3. So if T3 is less than V, you go to 5. What is 5? That is, you are having the starting place. So 5 is starting place, that is I equal to I plus 1. Similarly, you can convert all the variables into 3 address code. Next equal to J equal to J minus 1. So J equal to J minus 1. Then you are having A of J. E of J, J occupies 4 bytes. J is the number of elements in an array. So that should be multiplied into 4. So that is assigned to T4. E of T4 is assigned to T5. Then that is compared E of J greater than V. So if it is V, then it will go to the do loop. That is J equal to J minus 1. So go to 9. Then you are having the statement if I greater than or equal to J. Y greater than or equal to J, go to 23. Then you are having the X is equal to A of I, A of I equal to A of J, A of J equal to X. These are all converted here. Similarly, you convert these statements also. So this is the three address statement for the quick start algorithm. Next, we have to split these into blocks. What is block? It is a set of statements that have the entry point and also exit point. Always the first statement of a three-address statement is a leader. So you can take first one is the leader. Then any conditional or unconditional jump is the leader. So here you are having the T3 less than V go to 5. So that goes to the 5i. So this is a leader. So first statement is a leader. Then you are having the conditional go to. So fifth statement is a leader. Applying third rule, by applying third rule, the immediate statement of the conditional statement is a leader. So statement 9 is also a leader. So first statement is leader, fifth statement is leader, ninth statement is leader. Then you are having the conditional go to 9. So ninth statement is already leader. Next, the immediate statement to the next statement is a leader. So this is a leader. Then that will go to 23. So 23 is a leader. The next statement immediate to the conditional go to is a leader. So T6 is a leader. Similarly, you identify the leaders. The set of statements between the leaders are considered as the block. See here, we are having the block M1 to 4 is the block 1. Then 5 to 8 is the block 2. Then 9 to 12 is the another block. Then 13 is the another block. Then 14 to 21 is the another block. 22. Then 23 to 30 is the another block. 23 is the, so you are having the different blocks. Here you are having the 5 blocks. Then you have to draw the flow graph. See this go to 5. 5 is the block 2. So go to B2, that goes to the block 2. Similarly, go to block 3, 9. So go to block 3. Next, if I greater than J, go to 23. If I greater than J, go to 23. 23 is the block 6. So block 6. The remaining thing is block 5. Then in block 5, you are having the condition go to 5. 5 is in the block 2. So 5 to block 2. So similarly, you draw the flow graph. After constructing the flow graph, you are having the some of the transformations. When two basic blocks are said to be equivalent, if they compute the same set of expressions. So you can have the two blocks, these two blocks have the same set of statements. So you can say these two blocks are same blocks. Next, we are having the two types of transformations, structure preserving transformations, algebraic transformations. In structure preserving transformations, you are having common sub-expression elimination, dead code elimination, renaming temporary variables, interchanging statements. So we'll see how to eliminate the common sub-expressions. See, these are all the pre-order statements. A equal to B plus C, B equal to A minus D, C equal to B plus C, D equal to A minus D. See here, you are having the two common sub-expressions, B plus C, B plus C. Similarly, you can have A minus D, A minus D. These are all common sub-expressions. In this, A minus D is the common sub-expression. B plus C is not a common sub-expression. We'll see how. See here, B plus C. After adding these two variables, you can have the resulting A. Next, D is subtracted from the result A. Here, that is assigned to the B value. Suppose if you assume B value is 3 here, here B value is updated. Here you are having the updated B value. It is not 3. Here you are having 3. Here B value is updated. So here B value is an updated value. It is not same. So these two are all not common sub-expressions. But you can see the A minus D statements. Here you are having the A value. This A value, D is subtracted from this A value. Here you are not changing any A value or D value. Again you are having the A minus D. Now you can take these two statements are common sub-expressions. So you can eliminate this. So A minus D is replaced by the another variable B. Because A minus D are common sub-expressions. Both are assigned to B and D. So you can eliminate this A minus D. Instead of that, you can replace B. So after common sub-expression, you can have the D equal to B. I think you know why B plus C is not a common sub-expression here. That is, B value is 3 here, but here B value is updated by subtracting the B value from A. So the same value will not be, the same value 3 will not be retained here. So B plus C is not a common sub-expression here. It's renaming temporary variables. For example, you are having the statement t equal to b plus c. You can change the temporary variable t by u. When you are changing the temporary variable t by u, this will not change any output. That is, u is a new temporary variable and all instances of t are changed to u, then the basic plot remains unchanged. You can change the temporary variables. That is, you can rename the temporary variables here. Next, interchange of statements. That is, here you are having the two statements t1 equal to b plus c, t2 equal to x plus y. You can interchange these two statements. During the interchange, the value b plus c will not be assigned to t2. Similarly, the value x plus y will not be assigned to t1. During the interchange, b plus c is always assigned to t1, x plus y is always assigned to t2. That is, it can be interchanged without affecting the value of the plot if and only if neither x nor y is t1. That is, x and y should be in t2. And neither b nor c is t2. That is, b and c should be in the t1, not t2. Next, you are having the algebraic transformations. Here you are having the statement x is equal to x plus 0 and x is equal to x star 1. Here you already know whatever variable is added with the 0, you can have the same value. So instead of x plus 0, you can have the x. Similarly, whatever value is multiplied by 1, you can have the value is 1. So here you can eliminate x plus 0 and you can retain the value as x. You see here x is equal to y power 2. It is a exponential expression. So it can be replaced by y into y. When you are doing the algebraic transformations, the cost of the expression is reduced. And is always exponential cost is high compared to the multiplication. So y power 2 is changed into y into y. So in the here cost is reduced. So when your cost is reduced, automatically your code is optimized.